Hello everyone! In this video, we will demonstrate how you can set up classroom equipment for dual teaching. The classroom we have selected in this video is a classic classroom, such as those in KK Learn Building. Once you arrive at the classroom, switch on the classroom lights and the projector screen. You should also switch on and try out the AV cabinet to test the volume when using a microphone in the classroom. Locate and use the remote to turn on the projector, which is linked with a classroom webcam. Turn on the classroom computer and log into Zoom. Please double check Zoom is logging with your Hong Kong U account. In Zoom video setting, select one camera the best teacher needs. For example, select the Logitech webcam to allow students to see the teachers from a whole view. Or select integrated webcam to allow students to see the teacher's face. Don't forget to switch on the webcam, which is on the top of the classroom computer. To share your screen or lecture slides, click Share Screen in Zoom. Next is to check your audio. Locate the wireless mic in the classroom and switch it on. Then test your audio with your in-class face-to-face students and online students. You can turn up and down the volume for the best audio setup. In Zoom audio settings, select Line In and Astron HDMI as the microphone and the speaker. This will broadcast the sounds of the classroom computer to the loudspeakers throughout the classroom for the in-class students. If you don't want to use Zoom cloud recordings, you can use Panopto for recording your lecture. Log in Panopto using your Hong Kong U account. Under Primary Sources, select None as the video, select the Line In and Audio, and tick the Capture Computer Audio checkbox. Under Secondary Sources, tick the Capture PowerPoint and Capture Main Screen checkboxes for recording your PowerPoint slides and screen. Don't forget to enable Screen Capture Preview and modify the resolution to the maximum for the best resolution of the recording. Click Record to start recording. Then you can jump back to your Zoom classroom for teaching. You can pause and resume the recording using the button. If you want to end the recording, just click Stop and Done to save the recording, and you can manage your recording on this page. There are two things you need to know if you want to use the visualizer in your lecture. Number one, to set up the visualizer. Don't forget to bring in your pen and paper. Switch on the visualizer, then try out the functions Freeze, Focus, Zoom In, and Out. The Freeze button allows you to freeze the frame and walk away from the visualizer to the projector screen during the lecture. Press Focus button to adjust the autofocus. You can also zoom in and zoom out. If you find the visualizer is not responding, switch off and switch on to reset. Number 2. To share visualizer camera in Zoom on your classroom computer, click Share Screen in Zoom, go to Advanced, and select Content from Second Camera. Click Switch Camera if necessary. If you see a rotate view, please go to Video Setting. Click 90 degrees to rotate the visualizer view in Zoom. If you want to bring in your own computer for teaching, you need to log into Zoom on both of the classroom computer and your own computer. Because the audio system, including the microphone and the loudspeakers, the projector, and the visualizer in the classroom only work through sharing by the classroom computer. In the Zoom on your own computer, click Share Screen to share your screen or lecture slides. If you would like the in-class face-to-face students to interact with their peers online, here are some quick tips for the in-class face-to-face students. Please remind your students to bring their earphones to class. Log in Zoom and join the Zoom meeting. They can share their ideas or ask questions in Zoom using their earphones so that their peers online can hear what they say. They can also join the breakout sections to discuss with their peers online. If you need any immediate support in class, please contact Learning Environment Services for support. You can find the inquiry hotlines on the Quick Start Guide in the classroom. Thank you for your watching. See you next time.